Hi, I'm Torben Janssen from thoughtsonjava.org with the new Hibernate tip. This time I will show you how to detach entities from your persistence context. As I explained in one of my previous videos and in my Hibernate performance tuning training, when you need to update or delete a huge number of entities, it is often better to use a JPQL or SQA statement instead of updating one entity after the other. Instead of performing at least one query for each updated entity, you then just need to execute one query. But the JPQL or SQA statement also has a disadvantage. Hibernate doesn't know which database records you are updating and can't replicate the changes to the entities stored in the persistence context or first-level cache. You therefore need to do that yourself and detach all entities from the persistence context before you execute the query. That's when I always get the same question. How do you detach an entity from the persistence context? You can do that in two steps. First, make sure that Hibernate persisted all pending changes in the database. And second, remove the entities from the persistence context. Step one is crucial because Hibernate delays the execution of all write operations as long as possible. Your persistence context might contain new entities which were not inserted into the database or dirty entities that require the execution of an SQL update statement. When you detach these entities from the persistence context, Hibernate will not perform the required SQA statements, and you will lose these pending changes. You can prevent that by calling the flush method on the entity manager. After you've done that, you can remove a specific entity from the persistence context by calling the detach method, or you can call the clear method to clear the persistence context completely. I prepared a simple example. I first load the book entity with ID 1 from the database and write it to the log file. Then I change the title attribute. The entity is now dirty and Hibernate will generate an SQL update statement for it when it flushes the persistence context. In the next step, I trigger the flush by calling the flush method on the entity manager. Hibernate now performs a dirty check on all managed entities and executes the required SQA statements to write all pending changes to the database. Now I can call the clear method to detach all entities without losing any pending changes. After this is done, I can execute a JPQL update query and change the price of all entities. When I now call the entity manager find method, Hibernate has to execute an SQL query because the book entity is no longer managed by the persistence context. The database returns the updated record, and this log statement will write the entity with the updated title and price to the log file. Here you can see the log messages. Hibernate performs an SQA select statement to get the book entity with ID 1 before I write it to the log file. This update statement was triggered by the change of the title attribute and the call of the flush method. The changed title is now stored in the database. Hibernate then performs the JPQL update statement to update the price and another SQL select statement to retrieve the book entity with ID 1. As you can see here, the title and the price are now updated. Okay, that's it for today. If you want to learn more about Hibernate, you should join the free Thoughts on Java library. It gives you free access to a lot of member-only content, like an ebook about the Java 8 support in Hibernate, a printable PDF version of this Hibernate tip, lots of cheat sheets, and a video course. I'll add the link to it to the video description below. See you next week for a new Hibernate tip, and if you liked today's video, please give it a thumbs up and subscribe below. Bye!